CNN's Brian Stelter fabricated another doomsday scenario this weekend. This is what the mainstream media does when they have no policy arguments left. When they can't argue that the economy is doing badly, they can't argue Trump is guilty of something or another, they can't argue that Republicans are turning against Trump, because none of that is true. So they make up another doomsday scenario. Or rather, they revert back to paranoid screams of, Trump is an authoritarian. Listen.
Here's a mental exercise to apply to the news in the Trump age. What would you think if this were happening in some other country? Imagine how we'd cover the news if it were from Canada, Greece, New Zealand. Right now, the news is about a president who spends time demonizing immigrants and spreading misinformation and accusing his opponents of treason. This week, he threatened to close the border, then backtracked, and this is all considered just a normal day.
Yes, let's play this game. Imagine what you would think if this were happening in some other country. Imagine if you lived abroad and you listened to CNN tell you for 2 years that President Trump is guilty of collusion with Russia. Imagine if you lived abroad and heard CNN report that Attorney General Jeff Sessions colluded with Russia because he didn't report meetings with a Russian ambassador on his security clearance forms. But then you found out that was fake news. CNN was lying. The FBI told Sessions he did not need to report those meetings during the course of his duties as a senator. Imagine if you lived abroad and heard CNN report that Trump's former lawyer, Michael Cohen, was preparing to testify to Robert Mueller that Trump knew about the Trump Tower meeting in advance. But then you found out this was fake news from CNN. Cohen's lawyer said Cohen had no such information. Imagine you lived abroad and heard CNN report that former Trump communications director Anthony Scaramucci was being investigated for a meeting with a Russian banker before Trump's inauguration. But then you found out, again, that was fake news from CNN. It never happened. Imagine you lived abroad and heard CNN report that former FBI Director James Comey was prepared to testify to Congress that he did not tell Trump that Trump was not under investigation. CNN said this was a smoking gun. It contradicted Trump's claims and proved Trump had something Russia-related to hide. But then you found out, this is just more fake news from CNN. Comey actually testified he did tell Trump he wasn't under investigation. Here's an exercise for you in the Trump age. Would such fake news from CNN be considered just a normal day? What would you think of CNN's coverage if their headlines were happening in any other country? You would label CNN propaganda. It's a word that gets hurled around so often, every time a Democrat doesn't agree with the facts reported by us or any other right-leaning network, that it's almost lost its meaning. This is the definition of propaganda. Information, ideas, or rumors deliberately spread widely to help or harm a person, group, movement, institution, or nation. CNN is one of the guiltiest parties perpetuating the Russia conspiracy theories when they knew there was no smoking gun. CNN knew there was no proof, no evidence of wrongdoing by Trump. But they're so engrossed in proving what they want to believe that CNN is willfully blind to the truth right in front of their face. The Mueller report summary is in. President Trump did not collude, period. And yet CNN lied to drag out this nonsense for 2 years. So now Brian Stelter is trying to cover his tracks. His ratings are plummeting. Everyone knows CNN is a hack. And so he's trying to paint Trump as an authoritarian. But he's doing the same thing that got CNN into trouble before. He's lying. He's ignoring the facts. The fact is, President Trump takes more questions from hostile reporters than any other president in modern history. Just because it's not always in Stelter's preferred format, a circus on live TV that he can exploit for ratings, Stelter ignores the truth. The truth is, no matter how unfair, no matter how dishonest, no matter how many lies or conspiracy theories or downright slander hurled at the president by the mainstream media is still free, without fear for their lives or the lives of their families or even their livelihoods, to say whatever they want to say about the president, no matter how awful. The president has never stifled the freedom of the press in any way, shape, or form. So answer me this. How would this be covered if this were happening in a different country? We may never know, because in other countries, the press doesn't have the freedom to oppose and criticize the president like CNN does here. And that's my final point.